Hello, from Shraddha from Love Bites. Today I'm bringing to you chocolate tarts. Don't worry, it's a simple recipe. The tart is actually really easy to do. I've explained it well in the video. Do follow it well and you won't go wrong. And chocolate, who doesn't love chocolate? So the ganache is simple. You can do the caramelized hazelnuts like I've done. But I've not done a video, I've done it for something else and I've added it on top. You can add sprinkles if you want to, you can add chocolate pieces if you want to. Anything, you don't have to add anything at all actually. This is just good enough on its own. It's really, really delish. Do give it a try, do like, do subscribe, click on the bell icon for notifications. Love you guys, thank you, bye-bye.
For our chocolate tart recipe, we have to beat softened butter. In this, we have to add some caster sugar and now beat it. So my beating work is done and now we are going to add in the flour. Here's the flour. So just mix the butter, sugar and the flour to form a dough now. So here's the dough. Now keep it in the freezer for 15 to 20 minutes till it hardens up a little. Not too much, enough so that you can roll it out. You can cling wrap and keep it. I don't have, so I'm just keeping it in a dish, covered well. I've got the dough out from the fridge. And now I'm going to just weigh it and divide it into how many ever pieces we need. Take two parchment sheets. Just put the dough in between. Take another sheet on top. Take your rolling pin and just roll it. Make sure it's the same level everywhere, not thick and not thin. And just roll it a little larger than the tin. If you roll it between two parchment papers, it'll really make it easy for you. Make sure there are no cracks because when we do the filling later, there'll be a problem. Don't roll it out too thin. Take a knife and just lightly chop this off. Do it a bit neatly. I'm going to keep this in the fridge for now because we yet to roll our other tart molds. So we'll keep this in the fridge and once all are done, we're going to shift it to the freezer. Take a fork and just prick it. You can also do this just before baking.
The molds have all been filled. Now I'm going to keep it in the freezer for half an hour. Preheat our ovens and then we'll put this to bake. Let's make the ganache for our chocolate tarts. So take some cream, just warm it. You can do it on the stovetop. I'm doing it in the microwave. I finely chop some dark chocolate. I prefer the dark chocolate in this because of the sweetness of the tart. But you can take semi-sweet, milk chocolate, whatever you like. Let's just pour it over the chocolate. And just mix it till it's all smooth and even and there are no lumps left. My oven's preheated. I'm going to blind bake these. Just take a little parchment and take anything that you have, rajma, chola, whatever you want. Just keep them in this. So this helps for baking and doesn't let your pies puff up. Sometimes even after doing the fork, they still tend to come up a bit. You can save these beans and just keep them as your pie beans for later. You don't have to throw them. You also get those other balls in the market, especially for pies. I mean, you can get those if you want, but I've never wanted to buy anything extra. So the oven's preheated to 190 degrees and then we'll just keep it inside for 15 minutes or less till you think your pie is baked. Let's check. It's been 15 minutes. Off the parchment with the beans. And just put it back in for 5 minutes or so to get an even browning in this.
Yes, they're done. Let's get them out.
And just let it cool. Then we'll do the ganache in this. So our tarts have cooled. Let's unmold it. It's beautifully baked. Chocolate ganache which we had made. Now just put it in here. After you've added the ganache, just swirl it a bit. If you have a piping bag, you can pipe it also. I had caramelized some hazelnuts and kept, or pralines as you call them. I'm going to use these to decorate. This is totally up to you. You want to do it or you don't want to do it. You can use sprinkles. You don't have to use this. Anything you can use.
So the tarts are ready. They make a beautiful, delicious dessert. Hope you like them. Do try it. It's not that difficult. It's actually a very easy tart to make and you'll get better at it as and when you keep making it. Thank you.